On digital. I never thought I'd be talking about that thing again. I covered the service back in episode 46, but for a quick recap, it was the first digital terrestrial TV service in the world. It had numerous problems ranging from weak signals to piracy, but if you're a kid looking for some Cartoon Network, it looks and works perfectly fine. It's an excellent example of something nostalgic that can also be garbage. Unless you're my wife, in which case you're looking at Space Jam. If I was lucky enough to have access to the main TV instead of being stuck with a limited supply of VHS tapes, more than likely I was watching Cartoon Network. It worked for kids. I've made that clear dozens of times. So let's talk about something else. Three channels after the network on Channel 30 was Granada Plus. You'd see shows like Emmerdale, Cagney and Lacey, Minder, Terry and June, standard dramas, soaps and sitcoms from the 60s to the 90s. For British viewers, it was discount UK gold. I was 7 years old, so logically this channel would serve as much purpose to me as BBC Knowledge or something like Eurosport. But there was one show I used to watch on Granada.
The Dukes of Hazzard is on Plus.
You mean Bo and Luke Duke?
Come and pay homage to the Dukes of Hazzard weekdays at 5 on Plus.
The Dukes of Hazzard, the classic show featuring Bo and Luke Duke and their adventures protecting Hazzard County from the likes of Boss Hogg, Sheriff Roscoe Coltrane, and their many nefarious schemes. A show with very shaky beginnings that later became a family-friendly staple for the first half of the 80s. I wasn't born into this world until 1993, so naturally I missed the show during its heyday. But hey, it aired in the UK pretty early, and when I caught it on Granada Plus, probably after an airing of Cagney and Lacey, one of my mum's favourites to this very day, I thought it was a fun show. Sure, as a kid, I barely understood what the episode plots were, but the characters were good, the action sequences were exciting, and the General Lee was cool as shit. All that being said, I can't say I was anything more than a casual viewer. The show didn't have the best time slot for me, and if I was lucky enough to be given the power of the TV remote, take a guess what I'd go first. I enjoyed the show, but I couldn't tell you about the majority of the stories or about certain characters that appeared in one specific episode. Even when our TV services were upgraded and I was given complete access to ON, I doubt I was sitting down to watch The Dukes every night. If anything, I was lucky if I saw it once a week. But hey, even if I didn't consistently watch on the level of talking trains or Japanese monsters kept in minuscule capsules, I remained a fan of the Dukes. I even owned a few DVD sets in later years. Sure, the show did feel a bit dated in places, but it was still a decent way of killing a few hours. There was one more thing though. Portugal, summer 2005. Yep, we're back here again. We're at Forum Algarve, a large shopping centre in the middle of Faro. The same shopping centre where I picked up a set of Looney Tunes DVDs only the previous year. A lot of stuff happened here. I actually completed the collection recently. Excellent stuff. These are still my favourite DVDs in my collection. The 5-star rating stands. Anyway, Forum Algarve has a movie theatre, Cinema Nosh. What the NOSH stands for, I don't know.
Bem-vindo ao mundo digital dos cinemas NOSH.
That summer, this theater was showing a new movie I didn't even know existed. Shit. Well, I'm 12 years old, my mother wants to do some shopping, this place is showing the movie in English. This is an excellent place to leave me for an hour or two. I went, I saw the movie, and the theatre was completely empty the entire film. Having an entire cinema room to yourself is pretty sweet, especially in the childhood years. Either way, the movie was a lot of fun, and I immediately snatched it up on DVD. I thought the movie was excellent. That being said, I was 12 years old, and I had terrible taste. Many lovers of the TV show have called the movie atrocious garbage. And to be fair, they're not wrong, the movie is terrible. But I don't think it's one of the worst movies ever made. Let's have a look at it. For those who haven't seen this masterpiece, here's a recap. Bo and Luke deliver moonshine. Luke tries to get laid. Bo and Luke get chased. Jump. Title sequence. Bo and Luke crash into tractors and shit. Bar fight. Duke Farm gets seized. Bo and Luke investigate Boss Hogg. They find a safe. Jackass stunt sequence. They take the safe to Conspiracy Friend. Safe go boom. Weird container inside. Dukes go to Atlanta. Dukes find old girlfriend with Australian roommate. Weird container contains coal. Boss Hogg plans to mine Hazzard. Bo and Luke get arrested. Bo and Luke break free. Big car chase. Duke boys return to Hazzard. Jesse and family friend get rescued. Another car chase. Plan B. Bo enters big race with police. Moonshine explodes. Bo wins race. Everyone follows him to the courthouse. Judge dismisses mining order. Boss Hogg loses. That's about it. It's a special movie. Like I said, most fans of the TV show consider the movie to be an insult, and they're not necessarily wrong. The stunt work is pretty good, the car chase scenes are entertaining, but the movie is trying way too hard to be crude and edgy. The original show was seen as family friendly, and the humor here is mostly juvenile and vulgar. The plot is a bit extreme for Boss Hogg standards, and the dialogue feels like it was written by a group of teenagers.
You don't know how we're going to pay you back, Cole.
Would a BJ from Daisy be within the realm of possibility?
No, I got it.
The biggest offense to the movie has to be the casting. David Koechner and Michael Weston are okay as Cooter and Enos. Jessica Simpson is passable as Daisy, even though she doesn't get to do much beyond, well, that. And Burt Reynolds is fine despite looking nothing like his character from the show. On the other hand, Bo and Luke are nothing like their TV counterparts. MC Gainey is a great actor, I loved him in Con Air, but he plays Roscoe way too seriously. Roscoe was briefly serious in the first season of the show, but by season 2 he became the bumbling comic relief the character is known for.
Boss, what's a 5-letter word for dunce?
R-O-S-C-O.
Ooh, that fits.
The biggest offender here is Willie Nelson as Uncle Jesse. In the TV show, Jesse acts as the traditional father figure to Bo, Luke and Daisy, always on hand to offer support and wisdom whenever they need it. In the movie, Jesse is a hippie smartmouth, always cracking jokes, such as...
You know what you get when you cross a donkey with an onion?
No!
You get a piece of ass that'll bring a tear to your eye.
Woo!
Beyond that, there's not much to say. If you grew up on and loved the show, you will more than likely hate this movie, and I wouldn't blame you. Speaking as a casual viewer of the show, I don't think it's the worst movie ever made. It's watchable garbage at best. Normally, the film would warrant a 1-star rating, but if I'm being honest, I really enjoyed the last 20 minutes of the movie. When Bo enters the Hazzard Road rally in the middle of a police chase, the movie actually picks up for a bit. For 10 minutes from the start of the race to when Bo and Luke arrive at the courthouse, the movie is actually fun and exciting, barring Jesse's awful dialogue. So you know what? I'm giving it the benefit of the doubt. 2 stars, and it's lucky to be getting that. Watch this movie if and only if you're in the mood to watch garbage. If you can't put aside the fact that the movie is atrocious compared to the TV show, you won't make it.